Hello everybody. Today we're going to be taking a look at the new ToolsTalk MicroTorque software, as well as the MicroTorque Focus 6000 controller, the newest one in the MicroTorque family from Atlas Copco. To start off today, we're going to open up our ToolsTalk software, which we have installed, and then we're going to connect to our Focus controller. We will not be doing it using the Ethernet. Instead, we will be using a USB cable. So first I'll attach it to my computer. And then to the controller. Move that cable out of the way. Right away on screen, we see that the MTF 6000 is shown in our USB devices list. So I'll go ahead and double click on that. Now in the controller in the corner here, we see that the little TT icon shows up, which indicates that the controller is being controlled via ToolsTalk. So let me change my camera angle. And there you have it. So to start, let's make a new Pset. To do so, we're going to click up here in the top left corner on the single circle icon that says Manage a List of All Pset's. Right here, number one, we see that I have a Pset called MacBook Screws. That was one that I created for a previous video. So we're going to go ahead and click Add to create a new one. Pset number, we'll leave it at 2. As you can see, it scrolls all the way down to 250. We don't need to change the number that high. And we'll call this Demo Multi-Stage, since we will be doing multi-stage tightening. Perfect. Now I'll double click on the demo multi-stage, and we see we are now at the Pset 2 window for this specific fastening. Up top here we have general settings, which apply to everything for the Pset. So we have the name, the revision, the day it was created, the tool that's configured right now, which is the ETD M20 ABL version 2. And we have total time for fastening, max and min. We have limits for angle that we could set for trigger lost. We have different things for graphing and reporting, as well as what we want a final report angle to be, whether it's a step or clamp or tightening. And in the corner here, we have two different features which we could enable or disable, which are the bit slip detection and the damage thread detection. We'll leave them both on just in case I have any issues. Down here we go into the different steps. So there's four different tabs. The first one is tightening, the second one is loosening, and then we have controller results and screw pickup. We're not doing a screw pickup, we're gonna pretend that these screws are captive so that you don't need to use a automated screw pickup machine. For controller list view, we'll create three fields. So the first one we'll see peak torque, the second one we'll see the total angle, and then the third one we'll just do the Let's do tightening duration. Why not? For the other fields, we'll make it so that it's just showing the general information for each field type, not the step. For loosening, we want to set the max torque for loosening to the max for the tool. All the maxes and mins are going to be shown right next to the actual field, so 24 is our maximum. I only want to loosen these maybe 540 degrees each time because I'm going to be tightening and untightening and doing that a bunch of times over and over again. We'll change the loosening speed down to 300, so that's not too fast. We'll leave the max time at 10, and we're not using a vacuum pump, so we don't have to worry about these settings. All right, we'll move over to tightening now, and we already have one step that's automatically added in there, and we could change this step type from torque step to thread engagement step, or angle step, or a torque seating monitoring step. And each one of these have their own different variables which are going to go on. So say you had a seating control step, or you needed just to do a step before you started counting torque to engage the threads on, maybe you're using a certain plastic that's not cut too well. There's a lot of customizable options here which leave a ton of different options for how you set up your Pset's and, you know, to create the most accurate tightening profile you can. For this demo, we're just going to be doing torque steps to keep it simple. So for the first step, we'll start off fast at 100 RPM, which is the maximum for this step that we're allowed. And we'll go for an angle of 5 centinewton-meters and making sure that we're tightening clockwise. Leave the vacuum pump disabled, and we won't put any minimum torque values, but I will assign a maximum torque of 10. If it goes over that, then the Pset will fail and give us a not okay. We'll do no minimum angle, and we'll leave the maximum angle as is, since we're not worried about counting the angle, just about the torque. There's no startup delay that we want, and we don't have to worry about the triggers right now. So here's our first step. Now, I want all of these little screws to go down to 8 centinewton meters. So right now, this step is only going to screw them down to 5. So I'll add a second step here. We'll keep it the same. I'll even copy the first one by right-clicking, and then right-click on this one and paste it again. So now it tells us that step 1 was copied to step 2. So now I know everything's the same, and the only thing I want to change between the two, I could collapse this to get a better view, is I want the target torque on step 2 to go to 8 centinewton meters. So I'll change that, and then I want to change the speed. I want it to go a bit slower, so we'll put it down to 60, which is the minimum for this torque value. Once we're done with all that, we can review all of our changes. And then up here in the top right, there's an icon that will save all the changes permanently to the controller that we have plugged in. If you see this little exclamation mark in the corner, that means that you've made changes on ToolsTalk that haven't been applied. So once I click this, all changes are saved, and that little exclamation point is gone. So now we could switch back over to our tool. If I go to my results page, it says that we have our first piece set up here up top, so I want to change it to the second one. So I could do that by closing this menu, clicking on the... Actually, I want to leave it open, I guess. And I can click Activate up top. And right away, I get this error. I was expecting this, because right now the controller is in control of setting the presets. That's the source. We want to change the source to ToolsTalk or protocol, which would be if we plugged it in over the network. This way, we now control everything from our end. So we'll click OK, update the changes, and then we'll see on our controller that P2 demo multi-stage is now enabled. So let's go ahead and take a look at our controller now while we do a few rundowns on these screws. We'll start off in the default view, and I'll do one or two tightenings. So we got up to our peak of 8.023 centinewton meters, which is real close to what we were aiming for. And for the final step, it rotated 14 degrees. Now if I scroll through this list, we could see all the different results that we could see. Here we have step results. The first step occurred at 571 degrees. We hit 5.019 centinewton meters, and that took 1.055 seconds. And then the second step took only 14 degrees to get us up to 8 centinewton meters, and that took less than 0.2 seconds, for a grand total at the bottom of 8.023 at 585 degrees. The next step over here is going to show us a graph, and this graph can be a little hard to see on the controller, but it does give you a good view of what the joint profile looks like. The next one's not going to be applicable since we're not doing a batch sequence, and the final one is this custom view that we put up, which tells us our peak torque, our total angle, and the duration of our tightening. So we could leave it in this one and do another tightening. There you go. And you can see that all these values update in real time. We'll do another one. Now this one was not okay. If we go back to our main screen, you can see that it says that bit slip was detected. I wasn't holding this tool at the proper angle, or I wasn't applying enough pressure, and the bit slipped. The controller was able to recognize that and instantly stop the tightening process to protect the joint from any damage. Now say we wanted to see a bit more detail, we can go over onto ToolsTalk since we're still enabled, and we could open up the analysis real-time tracer. So let's do another joint, and this time we could see it on the big screen. There we go. So we get some cool information here. It is color-coded, so you'll see that the blue is our first step, where we started at 0, and we went all the way up to around 5 centinewton meters, and then it switched into step 2 at a lower RPM until it peaked at 8.05. Perfect. Now if I do another one, this graph will clear away and make room for the new one. But I could also click this box over here, which is show multiple traces. If I could grab this. Yeah, show multiple traces. So I'll collapse that. And now if I keep tightening, I'll see every trace stack on top of each other. So we could see how different each one of these screws is in terms of how much time it takes them to reach their peak torque. Two of them fell around the same amount of time. They all kind of, we don't have angle on here, so we only have time and torque. But you're able to change these values and of course see a value table of all your fastenings and all your steps. which is pretty cool. On top of seeing the graphs, we could see the results listed here. Oh, let me close this. So in this viewer now, we have our tightening results, and we could go through and see each fastening one at a time. It does save the angle and torque graphs down here, which is pretty cool. And we have every kind of information, every single value that you could ever imagine, all up and down here. And you could save all these results out to different formats on your computer. Pretty cool. You also have the ability to view step results for that last tightening, you know, which is very similar to what the step result view looks like on our controller. You could see the breakdown of each individual step. Each Pset can have up to 10 steps, so you could do a lot of creative things with just a single Pset for a single joint or a single fastener. And then on top of that, once we get into batch sequences in the next video, you'll see how much more we can integrate when we start using, you know, smart jigs and tool lights and barcode scanners and other accessories that we could plug into the device and have access to. Yeah, so make sure you tune in for our next video. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. And in the next one, yeah, we'll be going over batch sequencing using the MT Focus 6000 and ToolsTalk MT. Yeah, so thanks a lot for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. And if you'd like to see more content like this, be sure to subscribe to us and sign up for the alerts on YouTube. That way, every time we post a new video, you'll get an email or a notification, so you can be one of the first ones to check it out. See you next time.